This segment is sponsored by Horsey Orthodontics.
The doctor is in and you have questions. Today we're talking with Dr. Gus Horsey of Horsey Orthodontics. Dr. Gus, we're glad you're back with us. This is your third year.
Yeah, it's great to be back again. This event gets bigger and bigger each year, and we're really excited this year at the Richmond Wayside Complex.
It offers so much. We have switched locations this year, as you mentioned, this year out at the Richmond Raceway Complex. So this year, Thrive, the Women's Health and Fitness Expo, presented by CBS6, on Saturday, February 29th. So leap day.
Yeah, an extra day, which is great. And everybody should take this day for themselves. And this is a great opportunity for women to come out, learn about their health options, especially when it comes to orthodontics and how you can change your smile, your bite, your quality of life, your appearance, your self-esteem, all by changing your smile.
This is a pretty big deal, and you work with countless folks in our community. As we said when we got started, start smiling sooner, right?
Yeah.
You want to make sure that that happens, but sometimes you need a little help.
Absolutely. You don't know what to do or who to ask questions to. That's why this event is so great, because you get to talk one-on-one with doctors and professionals about your particular concerns, individually ask them questions about healthcare in your family or for yourself. And I really love interacting with the community in these types of events, because I get to kind of break down that wall and that stigma and that anxiety that a lot of patients have to make that first step.
You have been making a lot of steps in the community too. We were talking before we got started. You've opened that second location, and you're working on so many events out in the community, meeting people and meeting the need where it is.
Yeah, growing up in Richmond, I really love the community. I love the people. I love how Richmond has continued to thrive and transform these last couple decades. So I like getting out in the community, being able to talk to patients, to parents about their children's care, about their own care, and to give back when I can, because the community has given so much to me that giving back and volunteering at different events and being out there to support our communities, our PTAs, our different volunteer organizations is always a pleasure for me.
Some folks watching right now may be saying, well, braces are braces, and I had braces, and I know what braces are about, but there has been a lot of evolution in the technology and the capabilities of what you can do.
Oh yeah, just like everything else over the last 10 to 20 years, the technology boom has really affected orthodontics. There's obviously clear aligners, which a lot of patients know about, that can transform smiles very readily for a lot of patients. We also have hidden braces, which are braces that go behind the teeth that you don't have to see or take in and out, that move the teeth really effectively using digital technology. So the aesthetics of it has changed, the overall efficiency of treatment has changed. So treatment times are shorter, aesthetics are improved, patients can smile while they're in treatment. So there's a lot more comfort, there's a lot more convenience, and a lot more kind of satisfaction with treatment with patients nowadays versus 10 or 20 years ago.
And to be honest, if you were of the camp of maybe you never had braces and now you're thinking, woof, we really want to get some things straightened out, or I have some functionality issues,
yeah,
you can embrace that later in life.
Oh, definitely. Yeah. As long as you have teeth and a healthy dentition, you can definitely improve your smile as well as the function of your teeth, because everyone's keeping their teeth longer than our grandparents and great-grandparents. So it's important that they're in a functional bite, that the teeth are in a healthy position, so that long-term you don't wear and tear those teeth down prematurely now that patients are living longer and keeping their teeth longer.
And one of the things that we're appreciating a little bit more readily now too is when we get started with improving smiles at a young age for children.
Definitely. So a lot of the research will show that children as young as 7 need to at least be screened by an orthodontist so that we can take a look, see if there's things that we can do in growth and modification to prevent worse problems later on, so that patients can ease into orthodontic treatment without having to deal with more severe problems as teenagers.
That's a big difference. So in the olden days, you would think it might have just been in high school, and now as young as 7.
Definitely, yes. And at that age, the children are really excited nowadays because they know braces can be fun, they can be colorful, and their peer groups are already having those experiences. So getting children acclimated to braces at an earlier age a lot of times sets them up for success down the road, taking care of their dental health and oral health and being excited to see the dentist and the orthodontist.
That's good. Young and colorful if you're little, and then if you're an adult and you're worried about them just being hidden, that happens too. Thanks
so
much for being here.
Thank you.
It
was always a pleasure. Thank you.
Appreciate it. Horsey Orthodontics has two convenient locations, one office on East Perham Road in Henrico, and you'll find the second location at Westchester Commons in Midlothian. Find them online at horseyorthodontics.com and on Facebook at Horsey Ortho. They have a special offer, a free consultation and $0 down payment. Plus, Dr. Horsey will be with us at Thrive, the Women's Health and Fitness Expo presented by CBS6. It's coming up Saturday, February 29th from 10 a.m. to 4 p.m. at the Richmond Raceway Complex. We sure hope to see you there. For all the information, visit rvahealthexpo.com. Stay with us. Virginia This Morning is back right after a quick break.